Question is, where do young people go in the dark hours of a London night? Well, a rather bewildered Bill Wigmore has been seeking one answer by venturing into a place called the BatCave, just off Carnaby Street, where things happen on Wednesdays. Very curious.
Somewhere leather, somewhere lace, somewhere makeup on their face. Some are young, some are old.
Cabaret, live music, and a whole host of ghoulish patrons, the Batcave had it all. This London club helped establish and develop many aspects of the Gothic culture, from the music to the fashion, media, and even literature. Despite only running from 1982 until 1986, they achieved a lot in their 4 years. The Batcave was different to other clubs. They didn't add to the already overflowing and overfunded mainstream cultures. Instead, they embraced the weirdos of the world. The club had two rules that set them apart from the others. No funk and no disco. This made room for many bands we consider classically goth.
So for one evening a week, the dull uniformity of life on the dole behind a bank clerk's window or among all the office filing cabinets can be forgotten. In a make-believe world, even Walter Mitty would envy. The whole extravaganza doesn't start till 11 at night, at £3 to get in and 70 pence a can of lager. It's a dream world that comes quite cheap. If that is, you have the youth or the nerve to put on a little style.
I've waited hours for this. I've made myself so sick. I wish I'd stayed asleep today.
The club night was founded and run by Ollie Wisdom, lead singer of the band Specimen. This band is widely accredited as one of the pioneers of the Gothic subculture, both musically and stylistically. Every Wednesday night, an array of live bands would play, as well as DJ sets exploring the newest and trending Gothic, New Wave and rock music. The Cure's Robert Smith, Aliens, Sex, Fiends, Nick Fiend. Many names performed and frequented the club, but most notable is Susie and the Banshees' lead singer, Susie Sue. Dubbed the Godmother of Goth, Susie is often tracked back as the startings of Gothic culture. From her dramatic makeup, dark and moody songs, and even her melodic dance style, she is textbook goth.
Won't you come out to play?
This is a pair of tights. This is another pair of tights. This is my Kiss Kiss Bang Bang belt. This is lipsticks instead of silver bullets. This is part of our stage set. It's African stuff, but I don't really want to talk about clothes.
But as Julia says, clothes and fantasy is exactly what Batcave is all about.
All about self-expression, the Batcave was a hive for new and innovative fashion styles. As the alternative and gothic scene was still relatively new, there weren't many options to buy on the high street, and the options that were out there were not affordable to the mainstream audience. This meant that most people in the scene had to turn to making their own fashion to suit their alternative tastes. This meant a lot of second-hand or thrifted materials and sometimes very basic construction. Though what they may have sometimes lacked in technical detail, they made up for in originality and self-expression, which was what the Batcave was all about.
It's all based on something which is a little bit real. I mean, it's the people that make the atmosphere. You know, it's not suck your cheeks in and pose in the corner. It's very friendly, and it's basically about fun, and it's about having your tongue firmly in your cheek you know, and being able to laugh at the realities of the day-to-day existence.
For many, this Soho club was a place that they could go to be themselves, or someone else entirely. Similar to the present day, most Gothic people had quote-unquote normal lives outside of their Gothic interests, and the club was a way to forget normality and embrace their inner darkness, and a chance to listen to some great music. I hope you enjoyed your visit to the Batcave. Stay spooky!
The waltz is spinning. You have no choice, you hear laughter.